हॅलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर तुषार गुजराती फ्रॉम SNDT कॉलेज ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग येवला. टुडे विल स्टडी इम्पॉर्टंट टॉपिक बेस्ड ऑन सब्जेक्ट मेकाट्रॉनिक्स, दॅट इज प्रॉक्झिमिटी सेन्सर्स. दिस सेन्सर्स आर व्हेरी युजफुल इन मेनी ॲप्लिकेशन्स, सो विल स्टडी दिस नाव प्रॉक्झिमिटी सेन्सर्स. सो वॉट इज प्रॉक्झिमिटी सेन्सर्स? प्रॉक्झिमिटी ॲक्च्युली मिनिंग इज नियरनेस. ओके, सो प्रॉक्झिमिटी मीन्स वॉट? Nearness. So the proximity sensor is a sensor able to detect the presence of nearby objects by generating frequency without any contact with the object. What is the meaning of this statement? We can detect the presence of nearby object. Okay, we can detect presence of nearby object without contacting to that object. Okay, so this is the main aim of these proximity sensors. So electromagnetic radiation is emitted by proximity sensor. For instance, and looks for changes in the field or return signal. So what happens? Electromagnetic radiation is emitted by proximity sensor. And what are the changes in return that are noted? And in the next statement, the object being sensed is often referred to as proximity sensors target, depending on the proximity sensor target. Okay, so what happens? The distance is very important between the sensor and the target. Okay, so that distance should be in the range of that sensor so that it can be sensed. So this is the proximity sensor. Now there are different types of proximity sensors available. One is optical, second is inductive, third one is capacity. So we'll study these sensors now. What are the working of this sensor? What is the diagram that we'll study now? So we'll start with now inductive sensors, inductive proximity sensors. So what is working principle of these inductive sensors? It is based on electromagnetic induction. Okay, so this sensor is based on electromagnetic induction. So when electric signal is given, the coil generates magnetic field. So this is electromagnetic induction. The inductive sensor consists of sensing coil. So it has coil, which is ferromagnetic coil. So the coil is ferromagnetic, having copper turns. So this is the coil which we are using for this sensor. They only detect metallical targets and therefore use a magnetic field to its presence. So these sensors can detect metallic targets only. Okay, this you have to remember. We can detect only metallic targets. So this is the diagram of inductive proximity sensor. So it consists of one active phase. So this is active phase, here it is shown. This is active phase, okay, which is connected to this proximity switch. And this is the target that we have to be detect. Okay, that this target we have to detect. The same thing is shown below diagram. So what is inside this proximity sensor that it is shown? So it consists of one coil. Okay, this is the coil. So here it is, coil is shown. Okay, this coil is connected to this current sensor and as well as oscillator. Okay, so what is the use of here oscillator? So because of DC supply input, so here it is DC supply input. This oscillator generates oscillating supply. Okay, so this oscillating supply is given to this coil, and this coil also gets changing magnetic field. Okay, this coil develops changing magnetic field. So this is here, everywhere it is magnetic field. Okay, so we get magnetic field generated because of this coil. And when any object comes here in this magnetic field, what happens? The eddy currents are developed on this surface. Whatever surface is there of object, eddy currents are developed. Okay, and because of this, what happens? The amplitude gets decreased. So whatever amplitude is there here of magnetic field, that gets decreased, and this is sensed by this current sensor. This current sensor senses that change in magnetic field, and this gives us output, that is DC output, either normally open or normally closed, on or off. So like this, signal is given by DC output. Okay, so here what happens? When metallic object comes near this magnetic field, Eddy currents are developed on that surface of the object, and because of this, some energy gets lost in the original magnetic field. And because of this, the sensor senses this and gives us output either on or off, whether object is present or not. Okay, so like this inductive proximity sensor works. Now we'll study capacitive proximity sensor. The capacitive proximity sensor, on the other hand, can detect dielectric materials. We can detect dielectric materials here, such as liquid. We can detect plastic, glass, wood, and granulated substances as long as it is dielectric constant of 1.2. So we should have dielectric constant greater than 1.2. Such a materials we can detect with the help of proximity sensors. So capacitive sensor can detect metallic and non-metallic objects material. So here we can detect both type of materials, metallic as well as non-metallic objects. This is the capacitive proximity sensor. So now here, this is the diagram of capacitive proximity sensor. So here you can check, this is the capacitor plate. Okay, this is internal capacitor plate. So to this plate, one current sensor is attached. So this is current sensor. So this gets input supply from this DC supply, and in between them oscillator is placed. Okay. So here on right hand side, this is the object which to be detected. So this surface of this object is considered as effective capacitor plate in the target. So we assume this is surface as a one plate of capacitor, and in between both the plates, so this is plate and this is plate, there is air is available. Air is available, which is dielectric medium over here. Okay, so this air acts as a dielectric medium, and because of this, when this object tries to move towards left side, what happens? This dielectric medium changes, length of dielectric medium changes. Okay, and because of this, the current sensor senses it, and DC output is produced. Okay, and the output shows us whether object is present at particular position or not. Okay, so like this, nearby objects are detected with the help of capacitive sensor. So here, as you know, that symbol of capacitor is like this. Okay, so capacitor consists of two plates. So here, this is one plate of capacitor and this is another plate of capacitor. Okay, and in between them, what is there? Dielectric medium is there. So here air is dielectric medium. Okay, so when this distance changes, the capacitance changes, and this sensor produces then output either on or off. Okay, so like this, presence of object can be detected. Now we'll study next type, that is optical or photoelectric proximity sensor. So the name only suggests photoelectric, means we use here light sensitive element to detect object. So we have to use here light beam. So photoelectric proximity sensor may be AC or DC, which uses direct reflection. So we use here reflection phenomena. So in photoelectric, distance can be adjustable. So we can adjust the distances of sensors. Photoelectric sensor has greatest detection range from 1 mm to 25 meters or more. So depending upon sensors, different sensors have different range. So it can be from 1 mm to 25 meters. They operate by the use of an emitter which transmits a beam of light to the receiver. So in this sensor, we'll have two things. One is emitter and one is receiver. Emitter will emit the light and receiver will receive the light. Okay. So like this, it can operate. So this is the diagram of optical sensor. So here we can see the target to be detected is shown over here. So this is our target which is to be detected. So here we are using light beam. So that's why we have used here phototransmitter. Phototransmitter transmit lights, and that light gets reflected back from this target. Okay, and this is electronic receiver we have used. This electronic receiver removes background noise. okay, and like this object can be detected with the help of photoelectric proximity sensor. So this electronic receiver gives us output signal whether object is present or not, either on or off, okay. So this electronic receiver gives us output, and if target is moving, okay, so if target is moving, we'll get two types of laser light beams, okay, and this electronic receiver can remove the background noise and can show us whether output is present or not, either on or off, okay. So like this, it consists of phototransmitter and photoreceiver, which is useful for detection of object. So applications. So the proximity sensors have high long functional life. So this is the advantages. It has high functional life. It has high reliability due to absence of mechanical parts. So there are no mechanical parts, and there is no physical contact between the sensor and target. So that's why it has long life. Okay. So these are advantages actually. So inductive proximity sensors are used in elevators. So inductive sensors are usually used in elevators, that is lifts. Okay. And capacitive sensors are used to detect liquids and other dielectric materials on the manufacturing floor. So for detecting liquids and other dielectric material, we use capacitive sensors. And photoelectric sensors are used in our homes and countless other applications. So photoelectric sensors have wide advantages and applications. So thank you so much all of you for watching this video. Thank you so much.